Hi, my name is Scott, and I'm a solutions engineer, and today I'm here to talk to you about LogDNA's Views. Views allow you to filter your logs through various methods, which allow for quicker mean time to resolution. Have you noticed how fast our log data is being processed? This is because we parse and index upon ingestion, giving you instant access to the data. We start with our everything view, where we're seeing all of our logs coming into our system through a live tail. You can filter through our clickable filters at the top, which allow for quicker mean time to detection. By filtering, you narrow down your query to hone in on what you're interested in. Let's take a look at a scenario and how we can take action to quickly identify the root cause. So our Windows system is generating a lot of errors lately, and we need to investigate what's going on. We will see later how alerting would have given us a heads up that something was going wrong. We can find our Windows system and filter down just upon it. Next, we want to filter down on a particular app level. And lastly, we're interested in the errors that are being generated. We've now filtered down our logs, but what happened leading up to an error and did anything else happen after? We can expand the event line in View in Context. View in Context allows us to see the events both before and after a log line we are investigating. We've quickly and easily investigated the issue, identified the root cause, and can now work on steps to remediate. Let's take a look at another scenario using our natural language query syntax. We're getting reports of lots of SSH traffic coming through to our Linux systems, and for an SRE, it's causing a lot of noise in their alerting system and affecting users who need to connect to the system. We can filter using terms such as SSH, or if we're looking for particular users, we can append that to our search as well. We can also filter down via time, and time can be broken into relative time or absolute time. Relative time may be yesterday at 1 p.m., or if we switch to absolute time, where we can specify a date and time range as well. Time can also be filtered by using the timeline on the right-hand side. This can be helpful when you see abnormal spikes at certain time periods. The timeline allows us to easily drill in on a time range without having to type it in. One capability is the ability to color code different texts, which allow you to quickly see the lines you're interested in. Using the previous search, we looked for root in Ubuntu users. Let's look at how we can highlight those terms to bring them out to us. Now we can clearly see which lines maybe we're interested in that are coming from the Ubuntu side or the root user side. As we expand lines, we can see automatic parsing that happens upon ingestion. By using parse data, we may see other clues that we were previously unaware of, and we can quickly add or exclude them to the search query using the plus or minus options. By using parse fields for our searches, we can more granularly filter our results. Let's take a look at a search using specific terms, using our natural language query versus using parse fields and the results we get. So we can search for something like SSH Ubuntu, and we can see the results we get. But how do these compare if we were to use the parse data fields? So again, using that same example, we're looking for that Ubuntu user. Using the parse data field, it's going to look something like this. And we can see now our results are more focused on what we're looking for. So we saw the value of log lines being parsed and the potential for seeing items we were unaware of and how quickly we can add or exclude values from our filters. But what if log lines aren't automatically parsed? How does our platform help you as an SRE? With our custom parsing, we can take control of the logs being ingested and create custom parsing templates so that those unaware items now become aware and it puts you in control of the data coming into the platform. Lastly, we can save views. By saving a view, we don't need to worry about remembering what our search criteria was and allows us to share this view with other teammates as well as revisit the search later. The biggest value add you get from saving a view is the ability to do alerting. Alerting will give you insight into a potential issue that might be happening or that something is about to happen. Alerting would have helped us in our earlier scenario to give us a heads up that our Windows systems were generating a lot of errors. Not only do we have some out-of-the-box integrations with alerting, we can also support anything that supports a webhook. Alerting is based off of two things: presence of log lines in a given time period or the absence of log lines in a given period. Utilizing presence of alerts would be useful as systems are generating more errors or log lines, and absence would be useful if there is a large absence of log lines, Maybe the service or the system is down. When we are setting up an alert, we can also schedule when alerts are triggered. For example, during regular working hours, we may want to alert via email, but maybe on the weekends and off hours, we want to escalate these and have them pushed to pager duty where we know somebody is covering these. Head over to our website, logdna.com, to sign up for a 14-day trial and reach out to us with any questions.